Hi, let's talk about the pelvic autonomics. The pelvic autonomics are going to consist of two mixed plexuses, the superior hypogastric plexus, which is found outside of the pelvis, just at the bifurcation of the abdominal aorta, and then the inferior hypogastric plexus, which is going to be lateral to the viscera of the pelvis and is going to contribute to the vesical plexus, the uterovaginal plexus, and the rectal plexus. So these are mixed autonomic plexuses, and they're going to communicate by two sets of loosely associated fibers called the hypogastric nerves. So they have actually been severed right about here, so as to show some of the structures deep to this. So they are mixed autonomic plexuses, so the superior hypogastric plexus, the inferior hypogastric plexus, and the hypogastric nerves all have both sympathetic and parasympathetic components to it. Let's take a look at the sacral splanchnic nerves. So these are going to be part of the sympathetic influx to the inferior hypogastric plexus. So right here would be the first sacral sympathetic ganglion. Here's the second. There's the third. These are associated with what would be the ventral primary ramus of S1, S2, and S3. And typically, we're going to see these sacral splanchnics come from S1 and S2. We see a very strong sacral splanchnic extending down here from S2. I also see one coming down from S3 as well, which is kind of unusual because typically S1, S2, but here we have S2, S3. So sacral splanchnics are sympathetic, which is why I have colored them in with the orange. We also have pelvic splanchnics, which are parasympathetic. Pelvic splanchnics, as you recall, are branches from ventral primary rami of S2, S3, and S4. We can see a pelvic splanchnic there. You can see a pelvic splanchnic there, and I can see another pelvic splanchnic right there. And the last thought that I would leave you all with is that the ventral primary rami here of S1, S2, S3, and S4 are somatic, as is this lumbosacral trunk, which is fibers of L4 and L5 descending down from the lumbar plexus. And it's just certain fibers that are coming from S2, S3, and S4, which are parasympathetic in nature. Those other ventral primary rami of S2 through 4 are carrying a multitude of other fibers, most of which are somatic in nature. So don't assume that everything from S2 through S4 is parasympathetic. It's only those pelvic splanchnic nerves. So we've talked about the mixed autonomic plexuses, the sympathetic contributions to these mixed autonomic plexuses, as well as the parasympathetic contributions to them as well. Thank you for your time.